Hi, this is Tori, Creative Manager for Premier Yarns, and in this video, we're going to make this fuzzy chick in our eyelash yarn. All right, we're ready to get started. So you can find the pattern for the fuzzy chick at our website, www.premieryarns.com, and this chick is worked from the bottom up in the round. So we actually start here on the bottom and then work up in the round. I'm going to be using double pointed needles today, but you can use your preferred method for small circumference knitting in the round. We are also going to be using safety eyes, and these are approximately 8 to 10 millimeters, and we're going to be using a smooth orange yarn. This is pumpkin in our everyday worsted yarn. And for the eyes, if you are making this for a small child, we do recommend that you embroider the eyes instead of using safety eyes, as these can come out. So to begin, I'm going to cast on 4 stitches, and then once we do that, I'm going to join this in the round by rearranging my stitches. And I like to start on just 2 double pointed needles. And for today, in our first round, starts off with increases. So we are going to knit into the front and back of each stitch around. I like using a needle color that contrasts with the yarn I'm using. So you can see I've got these dark needles here. So the yellow really shows up nicely against them, and I can see where I'm putting my needle, where the stitches are, and it makes life easier. So we are on to the second round. So now we have doubled our stitches again. So we are now at 8 stitches per needle, and we are going to work a regular knit round. And you're just going to continue in this manner following the pattern, because our increase rate changes after the first 2 rounds. The next round is going to be knit front and back and then knit one. So each round we are going to be increasing on 8 stitches each increase round, and we're going to have an even round that is plain knit in between to help us form this circular base. So I'm going to finish up this base, and I'm going to show you our turning round next. All right, so I have just finished my purl round, and that is round 12 in the pattern. We have 48 stitches total, and at this point we are going to start working the body, and all that is we're just going to keep knitting in the round until we measure 4 inches from this round. So I've just completed round 5 of the head shaping, and this is where we're going to start adding our stuffing. And then once we have our chick partially stuffed, we're then going to add in the eyes and the nose. So let's get started on that. And this is where partially stuffing, we don't want it really firm to this point. We just want to get it started so we can get all the way down into the bottom and then get the eyes and the beak in place before we reduce the stitches for the head any further. And then once we get this partially stuffed, we don't want to stuff it too full, because we don't want the bottom to bulge out. We want it to stay nice and flat to make a good base for our chick to stand up. So keep that in mind when you're stuffing. We don't want it to be solid. We just want it to have a good squish to it. All right, so that's looking pretty good to me for now, because we're going to be adding all of our details right about here. I'm going to measure up. Now we are measuring from our purl row, and we want our eyes to be about 2.25 to 2.5 inches up from that purl round. And that, and add in our first eye. I like to get the first one placed, and then we can kind of figure everything out from there. So you can see I'm using the safety eye with a washer. And then we are going to place our eyes about 3/4 of an inch apart. It's kind of whatever, again, looks good to you and suits your preferences. I like to kind of move some of our fuzz out of the way to make it a little easier. I'm gonna make these a smidge wider. And that's so we have room for the top of our beak, because the beak starts pretty much right below. And here we go. We've got our eyes on there and ready. So next, I'm going to take our smooth orange yarn. And again, for this, I'm using our Everyday Worsted in Pumpkin. And this is just a great color for a beak. And so here we go. I'm going to go from the inside, and we're going to start just below, it's a little hard to see, just below where the eyes are in between. We're going to be doing satin stitch. So that we're just taking basically a bunch of long stitches right next to each other. So when I go in, I'm going to come out right next to where I went in. And for this, I'm going to put all my stitches in at the same spot, since we're making a triangle for our beak. And the goal here is to make our stitches tight without making them too tight and warping, because we want them tight enough to lay down that fuzz from our eyelash, but not so tight that it is distorting our piece. And we also want to make sure it's firm enough that it's not going to get snagged later on. And here we go. I like to do about 4 or 5 for this. And sometimes I'll come back in, or I'll go just below for our last one, so it creates that little bit of a point for our nose. So there we have our beak. So when I'm happy with the placement of that beak, I like to cut my yarn to a manageable size, and then I will go in and I'll tie a very loose square knot on the inside, because again, I don't want to pull the satin stitching too tight, because then it just kind of gets lost. So do that, and then I tuck it in with the rest of the stuffing. That's my favorite part about making stuffed toys, is that those ends, you just get them all inside. You don't have to worry about weaving in perfectly like you would on a garment or something like a blanket, where you'll see both sides. We just get those ends in there and out of the way, and just make sure they're secure enough that they're not going to come apart with a little snuggling from kiddos. All right, so this is good for now. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do the next few decrease rounds until we're about ready to fasten this off. And then if necessary, I'll add a little bit more stuffing, but this seems pretty good to me. I like him to be a little squishy, again, like I said, not too solid, so he doesn't get too distorted. And he's fun. You can kind of comb his little fluffy feathers out of the way. And to do this, let me finish this top and I will show you our last few steps. We are ready to close the top of our chick's head. So first we are going to cut our yarn, and I'm going to thread my tail onto my needle. So I'm going to work this just like you would the top of a hat. We've got 4 live stitches left, so I am just going to thread my yarn through all of them. Let me get these out of the way. And now you can go through again, and I'm also going to, before I pull it too tight, check and see if I want to add any additional stuffing in top. I add just a tiny bit, but not too much. So we are going to then pull those stitches tight. Next, I like to take that end and pull it down inside. Pull it tight, make sure everything is fluffing out well. Perfect. Now we are ready to add the wings. How we do this, and it's not, luckily with eyelash, it's not a big deal. We are going to get in here and just find a row. So like I said, I'm going about an inch over, and then I'm just going to pick up the edge, like a loop of each stitch. So at this point, we are just picking up half of each knit stitch across there. And you're going to want to pick up 6 of these loops. And I'm going to join the yarn. And we are just going to knit. And we are going to work this wing in garter stitch. So we are just going to knit a few rows. I'm going to go until we reach the desired length on our wing, and then I'm going to start the decreases. So I'll join you back here when we're ready. So I've worked my wing until it's about 3/4 to 1 inch long, and now we are ready to start our decreases. So it's doing slip, slip, knit. Knit 2, and then knit 2 together. And then in between, we are going to work an even row. We finished that, so we're back to our slip, slip, knit, and our knit 2 together. And then for the last one, we don't have an even row between this, we are going to knit those last 2 stitches together. And on this, instead of binding off that single stitch, we're just going to cut the yarn and pull it through that single remaining stitch. So you can see our little chick's wing here. So we are going to repeat that for the other side, weave in our ends, and you are all set with your fuzzy chick in eyelash. Thanks so much for joining me today.